from here in Los Angeles, Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas with you ringside. For these two men who understand how rare these opportunities are, a chance for redemption, a chance for a crowning achievement, a chance to be called champion. Michael Buffer will get us set.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please rise for the national anthem of the United States of America to be performed here in the ring by the USC Trojans Marching Band. And now coming to the ring first, Cristobal the Nightmare Arreola.
One year ago today, Chris Arreola was undergoing surgery on his nose, broken in four places the first time he met up with Bermaine Stiverne. Chance to avenge that loss tonight and take a giant leap forward and claim a heavyweight championship belt, trying to become the first Mexican-American heavyweight champion. Great reception here in his home of Southern California. He's from Riverside. So we're here at the Galen Center on the campus of USC.
And now making his entrance to the ring, Bermaine, beware
Haitian-born, raised in both Miami and Montreal, Canadian but hopeful soon to be naturalized American, fights out of Vegas, lives in Miami, well-traveled, and now comes to Los Angeles with it all on the line. Number two heavyweight in the world, according to ESPN.com. And so important to him to represent his heritage, trying to become the first Haitian to win a heavyweight title. He's in the midst of a 12-fight unbeaten streak. He's been training hard since December. Been working at Floyd Mayweather's gym in Las Vegas. Never been cut, never been knocked down. and scored that thunderous right hand that crashed home against Arreola at the end of round three in their first fight. And after a week of highly charged emotional confrontations at the final press conference and the weigh-in, now he steps to face Arreola for the belt.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Galen Center here on the campus of the University of Southern California, located in Los Angeles, California, USA. Tonight, Don King Productions and Goosen Promotions are proud to present the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC Heavyweight Championship of the World. Brought to you by La Cerveza Más Fina, Corona Extra, along with Ford Motor Company, AT&T, Exotic Eurocars, Brent's Deli, and Just for Men, along with the greatest name in the game, Everlast. This event is dedicated to the memory of former World Heavyweight Champion Jimmy Ellis. Sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission, Chairman John Frierson, Executive Director Andy Foster, WBC President Mauricio Suleiman, and Supervisor for the WBC is Craig Hubbell. At ringside, the three judges scoring, Max DeLuca, Jerry Roth, and Robert Tapper. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, World Championship veteran referee Jack Reese. And now, the officials are ready, the fighters are ready. So for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching, the worldwide leader in sports, ESPN, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white, trimmed with cardinal and gold, officially weighing 239 pounds. His professional career consists of 39 fights, 36 victories, including 31 knockouts with 3 defeats. From Riverside, California, representing his Mexican heritage, Damas y Caballeros, La Pesadilla, Cristobal, the Nightmare. And across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black with gold, officially weighing in at 239.5 pounds. In his professional career, 25 fights, 23 victories, including 20 wins by knockout, with 1 defeat and 1 draw. Originally from Haiti, but now fighting out of Miami, Florida, by way of Las Vegas, Nevada, he's the WBC Silver Belt Champion, Bermaine. Beware!
Jack Reese is the referee. He was outstanding with his work the first time these two met up. WBC heavyweight title on the line. Arreola Stiverne from here in Los Angeles.
Everybody out except the chief second.
Right about now, it gets kind of lonely in there for the fighters.
Mouthpiece.
No, you've been in this position training a fighter to the heavyweight championship.
This is a little bit higher in here, Don. I'm going to let him work. It ain't going to matter. Okay, I gave you both instructions in the dress room. And I remind you, listen and obey my commands at all time. Protect yourself at all time. Fight hard, fight clean. Good luck to both of you.
Stiverne has heard his first name pronounced every which way. Bermaine, Bermani, it's Berman. And tonight he wants to stamp it for everybody to know. Will he do it? He beat Arreola a year ago, broke his nose. Or will Chris Arreola, coming in lighter, tighter, primed, ready, finally climb to the top of the mountain? Teddy, noticeable with everybody in the ring with the pre-fight hype. This is a small, little, tight space. 17 by 17. What impact could that have?
The great, late Joe Louis once said they can run, but they can't hide. Neither one of these fighters are prone to running. They don't know how. But if they did, there'd be nowhere to go. They have to fight.
Arreola comes in first and puts a right hand behind the jab.
Everybody knows that Arreola needs to move his head more because sometimes he allows the opponent to move his head for him. And that's not good. But for me, it's more than that. Not just moving your head. You got to move your head in the right position, not from too far away. You do it from too far away, which he did in the first fight, then Stiverne lays back and times him. Times him when he comes in the middle. You must move that head at the right spot when you're close enough to draw the punch. Like right about now.
Ariel finding a little bit of early success, splitting the guard, doubling up the jab, and then Stiverne fires off and lands a right hand to the left flank of the Mexican-American.
What do we know about Stiverne? What does Arreola know about him? He's strong, he can punch. That should tell Arreola he should not stand in front of him. If you're not doing something and keeping him busy in front, move to the side. I know you're not Muhammad Ali, but you do have legs. Move to the side a little bit. Don't lay right in front. Not only to avoid head punches, but to avoid those body shots that took a lot out of you the first fight.
There's that left hand coming off the hip now of Stiverne. We saw plenty of that in their first go round. To the inside they go, and Arreola tried to get the best of it, turning over that left hand, looking for that right uppercut as well. Short right hand on the inside as Stiverne then throws a three-punch combination.
Now right now, Ariola's in good offensive position, but is he in good defensive position? His head is in the middle while he's throwing, leaving himself open to an uppercut.
And he just caught a right uppercut and then a left hook as Stiverne finds a moment of success and backs him up to the middle of the ring.
For me, when you get inside, yes, you want offense, but yes, you have to take care of your defensive responsibility. Get your head on the side where it's not easy to find. You're laying in the middle, even though you got your hands up, your guard could be split by that uppercut.
It was a wider right hand trying to get around that left guard of Arreola. No feeling out here. Picking up. They know right where they left off. They know each other well. Good competitive opening round here in Los Angeles for the WBC heavyweight title as they open up and he catches them.
What did I just finish saying? It's great for Arreola to get in good offensive position, but what about defense? He lays right in the middle, and when you lay right in the middle, guess what? The other man can come back and catch you in the middle. That's exactly what happened, what I was alluding to earlier in the round. Ariola's setting up offense, forgetting defense. You can't leave your head in the middle, especially with a guy that knows how to counter and a guy who can bang.
Bermaine Stiverne landing the two-punch combination in the final seconds of round number one. Good competitive opening stanza here for the heavyweight belt.
See, Arreola thinks that every time he's got to throw, I saw that in the gym with him, he's got to throw from the middle. No, no, no. Someone needs to teach him, and it's late now, obviously, but he has to understand you can throw from the side. You don't want to throw from the middle all the time. You throw from the middle, again, you leave yourself open to counter, and that's the fight that Stiverne is fighting right now, looking to counter right now off the rope.
Good exchange here in the opening minute of round two as Arreola found success with the left hand, splitting that guard and trying to bring a right hand behind it.
He's not moving his head, but you know what he's doing now? Give him credit, Arreola. He's using his legs for defense, getting off and then getting out. Main thing, not standing there waiting for the receipt.
Now a little more patient on the outside. Halfway through that first round, Stiverne picked up the pace. It was late in the first round. He scored well, much the case in their first meeting when he scored a crushing knockdown in the final seconds of round three.
Hey, it's great when you hurt a guy. You love it. But it can be a curse, especially early in the fight. Stiverne hurt Arreola in the first round. Sometimes then you just wait for that one shot again. And while you're waiting for it, you get out of hustle. So the corner of Stiverne and himself have to be careful that hurting Arreola early was not a curse.
Much more measured approach here. There's a lean right hand by Arreola as he backs Stiverne up, catches him on the left, sends in the uppercut.
See, right now, having hurt Arreola in the first round is a curse for Stiverne because he's looking for one shot instead of being a little more active like he was to set up that shot that hurt him.
And now look at Stiverne talking at Arreola as he snaps off that jab and tries to send the right uppercut in as well. Seemingly unaffected by the offensive surge in the middle of round number two here.
Box. See, again, Stiverne now assuming, taking for granted, you don't do that in life, and you don't do that in the square circle, that he's going to land another shot. And while he's waiting for that other shot, right now in the second round, Arreola having a good comeback round.
We've got life in the heavyweight division again. We're going to take a short break and be right back to LA, end of two. Corona Extra brings us tonight extra look. Watch the right hand from Arreola in that second round.
More importantly, watch the left hand of Stiverne. It's not up. That's what you got to watch. Left hand's not up, right hand gets in. We talked about it in the ORAT, talked about it in the fight plan. Exactly what we thought would be there for Arreola.
Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas with your ringside partner. We've been calling fights together for 13 years. For many of those years, this division dominated by the Klitschko brothers. Finally an opening. Vitaly Klitschko vacates, and we get this kind of an action fight that American fight fans have been craving in this division.
Both guys know what's at stake. It's fun. Fun for us.
Round three.
And I'm going to say it again. It can be a blessing to hurt a guy, and it can be a curse. So far, and we're very early, hurting Arreola, which Stiverne did at the end of the first round, has been a curse because he's been waiting for one shot again, and he's been outworked a little bit by Arreola.
Good snapping jab from Stiverne as Arreola tries to return a bit of fire.
Look, I know Stiverne has the speed of your hands, but people are going to call me crazy, but Arreola can out-jab him. You know why? Because there's stages to Stiverne's jab. He has to bring it up into that chamber. He starts in his hip. Take a look. He starts in his hip, and then he comes up to that midway chamber before he gets it off. That is an opportunity. That's a half a second. A half a second is a lifetime in that ring. That's an opportunity for Arreola to step into that gap and beat him with his jab. And he just beat him with the jab that time. That's where the corner needs to have eyes and pick up on that and tell him, listen, don't let him intimidate you with that jab. It might be quick, but it takes too long to get there. Get there first.
Angry exchanges here now, coming up on the minute mark in round three.
Guess what? Jab is starting to land by Arreola, and now that means other things are going to land by it.
Arreola sweeping right hand. He's on the attack. Stiverne tried to land in between there, but he was backed up.
Arreola wants to eat. And how do you eat? Well, you set the table with the jab, and then you go with the right hand, and you devour.
It was a right hand that had Stiverne backing up across the ring here. Now he sits right in the pocket.
You know, Arreola has not been slowed down the last two rounds. Why? One of the reasons, no body work by Stiverne. That body work the first time
took a lot
out of Arreola. And right now, nothing taken out of Arreola.
Final moments here of round three. And Chris Arreola is taking control here.
We know he wasn't in as good a shape as he is, but he also had a lot of steam taken out by body shots. No steam being taken out
Nobody
that
shots
jab on him.
By Stiverne. Arreola is showing the effects of not being hit to the body.
How you doing, bro?
Great.
Now start taking the shot to the body shot, man. Spending too much time on the rope.
Yeah, I know.
He's trying to attack you on the rope. Spending too much time here.
Hey, get that bucket down. That's the one you can't have up here.
I don't spend too much time on the rope. Get in it.
Going back, he can't do nothing, okay? When you're throwing that jab, okay?
Move inteligente, okay? Listen to me. Do not forget about his body. Dig, come back up on top, right? Don't just headhunt him. Don't headhunt on him, okay? When he's on the rope, touch him everywhere. Just don't headhunt.
You heard the corner of Stiverne, led by the veteran Don House, saying, get off the ropes. You're spending too much time on the ropes. Arreola had success with the jab Bermane and the right hand up top. But Henry Ramirez, his longtime trainer, says don't forget about the body. Round number four for the WBC Heavyweight Championship here in Southern California. Areola's home as he's trying to become the first Mexican-American heavyweight titleist.
Arreola has been cut over both eyes in his career. He's clean so far.
CompuBox, Teddy, shows the last round. Arreola a 41-18 connect advantage. He dominated that third round.
Yeah, and it started with the jab. The jab that a lot of people thought he couldn't get over on the quickest Stiverne. But as I pointed out in the second round, Stiverne does have the quicker hands, but he goes into phases to get them off. With that jab, he has to bring it up to a level before he throws it. That time wasted allows Arreola to beat him with the jab.
That is not where they want him, as he was up against the ropes again. Tried to throw a lead right hand, and now in the corner as Arreola looks to apply pressure, and there's a left hook that came crashing home as Stiverne stays sturdy and throws a punch back.
Well, when you go downstairs and you put water in the basement like Arreola just did, it leaves an opportunity to put a light on in the attic, and that's exactly what Arreola did, downstairs and then upstairs.
And they settle back here halfway through round four. Stiverne is talking to Arreola, taking tiny steps forward, popping that jab off the hip. Look at them talk, just like they've done the past 2 days.
Again, you got heavyweights here, everybody knows it's about the big punches. But for me, no, it's about the jab. And again, the quicker hands of Stiverne, he is not serving himself with that low left hand. He has to bring it up before he throws it, and it's allowing Arreola to get into that pocket, allowing him to get into that sweet spot where he can get off his jab before Stiverne gets it in position to flick his out.
CompuBox showing you there that the work rate of Arreola has gone up dramatically compared to their first encounter as Stiverne lands a combination here. Final half minute of round four.
Remember that big punch at the end of the first round? Ever since then, what has Stiverne been doing? Not moving his hands enough, waiting for that one shot. And what's Arreola doing? Marching forward, taking hills. And if you take enough hills, well, then you can take a title.
Both men trying to get work on the inside here. Good heavyweight title fight from LA. Stay with us. WBC World Heavyweight Championship brought to you by Corona Extra. Glad you were with Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas ringside in Los Angeles. A Saturday night of championship boxing that you don't have to pay $75 for and be disappointed, as the heavyweight division is giving you good entertainment early on here with the green belt on the line. Vitaly Klitschko vacated, leaves an opening for Bermane Stiverne and Chris Arreola, one man to be called champ tonight.
You know what's helping Arreola? We talked about different scenarios, you know, different components of this fight. But I'm going to tell you right now, one component no one's talked about that's helping and serving Arreola so far, activity. Arreola took an in-between fight. It's been 8 months since Arreola fought. He took a tune-up fight. Stiverne took no tune-up fight. It's been 1 year and 1 month since Stiverne last got in the ring. Arreola is a little sharper.
He bounced back with a win, a first-round knockout of Seth Mitchell. That was September of 2013. And then this came about. And he shaved off some weight, as did Stiverne, as he tries to get back to that jab in the center of the ring. Avoid the back against the ropes.
See that block of the right hand. Now, just a moment ago, Arreola blocked that jab of Stiverne's right hand. He moved that right hand over to block that jab. That leaves a little opening for that left hook. Stiverne has the quickness to turn that jab into that.
He nearly did it right there, Teddy, as he turned over that left hand and he got out the side door.
That's what I think he should be looking for. One of the things Stiverne should look for. Run something off that jab. Don't be satisfied just with the jab. Use the jab up. Use that jab for something else.
Now here's Arreola, where he has accomplished his best work so far tonight.
Yeah, this is where Stiverne's looking to counter. Looking to catch Arreola, taking a picture, admiring his work, not moving his head after his last punch. The problem is Arreola made a little adjustment after the first round. He's using those legs a little bit. He gets his punches off, uses his legs to get out of range. Doesn't hang around as much.
Great right hand, it was just a glancing blow that time. Stiverne misses with the looping right hand and then a hook that was off the mark. Boy, are they talking it up throughout this whole night.
Listen, Arreola's ahead in this fight for a reason. He's been busier. He's a little more tired right now than Stiverne. My eyes tell me for a reason, because he's been busier.
Time, stop punching, let me punch.
Fixture, so many big fights. There is Pete Rose sitting ringside to take in WBC heavyweight title bout. Mario Lopez, big fight fan, often seen working out at the local gyms here in LA, as we are at the Galen Center at UFC round number 6 between Arreola and Stiverne.
You know, we've talked a lot about the broken nose suffered by Arreola when he got dropped the first time in the first fight in the third round. What we haven't talked about is he also got cut over his left eye. There's a little redness around the eyes of Arreola. No blood, but a little redness.
Some moderate swelling as he tries to place that right hand again.
Again, activity is very important in anything you do. Arreola, last time he was in the ring, 8 months ago, he took a tune-up. Stiverne, 1 year,
oh,
1 month.
A sweeping right hand has Arreola on spaghetti legs and down.
6, 7, 8. You okay?
A lot
Can you
of time.
Yourself? Give me your gloves.
A lot
Give
of
me
time. Gloves.
Walk to me. Walk to me. No.
This is buying time. This is buying time for Arreola. Valuable time. He just bought himself 10 seconds.
Can he survive the big power of the Haitian slugger? Stiverne trying to hit a home run here in L.A. Headshot after headshot. Arreola doesn't look good at all. Second knockdown scored.
4, 5.
I'm looking right in his eyes, and I don't know that they're clear enough. Jack Reese has a decision to make here.
Legs ain't right, legs aren't right.
Give me your gloves.
Too much time.
You sure? You can defend yourself.
He's going to let it go.
Too much time.
Can he survive a minute?
Too much time.
Headshot after headshot. And that is it.
That's it, man. Too much, Chris.
The first Haitian-born fighter to win a heavyweight championship. Bermane Stiverne has toppled Arreola.
The great thing about power, You could be losing rounds, and you always have that great eraser that erases what happened in the previous rounds. You just saw that a great eraser at work by Stiverne.
You are going to see an outpouring of emotion from this 35-year-old who's prone and now will come to his feet. A young man who broke down yesterday prior to the weigh-in, simply discussing those who have supported him on his attempt to get to the top. His mom, Rosemary, took Berman and his sisters to Miami from Haiti when he was just 10 years old. She took work as a seamstress. She put herself through nursing school. The youngest son of 8 girls and 5 boys who had to earn every inch of it as a late bloomer to the game is now a heavyweight champion. And these two men who were in each other's faces for the past 2 days at the final presser and the weigh-in, showing what it means to be true competitors and warriors of this game. Moments ago, that right hand that's embracing Arreola was sending him to the canvas.
I'm gonna show you something. Believe me, I'll fuck with you anytime. Because you're real. All right?
It's Arreola, just couldn't survive. Final 2 minutes there. Let's go back, Teddy, to the first knockdown.
So you always hear me talk about one thing to throw a punch out, it's another thing to bring it back. That jab is thrown out slow. It comes out and it doesn't come back fast. Watch again, the left hand does not come back fast. The right hand gets over it, hits him on the temple. Bad place to get hit. Everyone thinks the chin's the only bad place. Temple, a very bad place to get hit. Throws your legs off, throws your equilibrium off, and it's hard to come back. Again, the right hand over the slow left hand of Arreola. It's one thing to throw the punch out. It's another thing to develop the habit of bringing it back fast before you can get caught with that right hand counter.
Here's the second knockdown, Teddy.
Again, he's already heard an accumulation of punches again. Not on the chin, around the head area, keeping Arreola in a place he doesn't want to be, in a place where everything is distorted, everything is fuzzy, and the legs just not working right.
Last look before Jack Reese had to say that he has seen enough.
Arreola coming forward, Stiverne doing a good job of actually counterpunching there, taking what's given him. As Ariola's head fell forward, Stiverne clipped off some nice counter shots again on the forehead area, keeping Arreola in that fuzzy place. But again, the big punch, the punch that made him champion of the world, the right hand over the slow left hand of Arreola. You throw that jab out, you got to bring it back fast. You got to test hot water. Arreola brought it back slow. It's Stiverne. He's the new heavyweight champ of the world in the WBC world.
Let's make it official. And for that, we send it up to Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 2 minutes and 2 seconds of round number 6. The winner by knockout victory. He is now the fighting pride of IET. And now, the WBC heavyweight champion of the world, Bermaine.
Won 13 straight fights. He does it decisively, with power, with a spectacular ending, a knockout victory. The 21st of his career, the 24th win, and the biggest moment of his professional life.
You see, Joe, when you're in there with a banger, with a TNT puncher, you can't make mistakes. Stiverne could make mistakes. He made them early. He was losing early rounds in this fight. I had him behind on the scorecard, on my scorecard. But when you can punch, and as I said earlier, you have that great eraser, you make up for all those mistakes. Arreola could not afford to make the mistakes that Stiverne could afford to make.
Bernardo is with the new champ.
That's right, and euphoria here in the ring with Bermaine Stiverne. Talk to me about the emotion of hearing those words, and new heavyweight champ.
I didn't even hear them yet. It was so loud, I didn't hear it. But damn. I mean,
it's okay, baby. It's okay, baby.
An emotional moment.
Okay. Right, man.
What was different this time around? You said you were going to knock him out, and you did.
Yeah, because I studied his tape. I watched my opponent, you know what I'm saying? And I know I could knock him out. So, you know, I came here with a vengeance. I was patient. He was getting gone. The plan was to let him get comfortable. And as soon as he get real comfortable, crack him. And that's what I did.
You had to walk through fire too, because in that second round it looked like he tagged you with a good shot. Talk to us about being hurt.
No, I wasn't hurt. He actually punched me. My mouth was open and he bust my lip. So I was trying to find out if it was some food that's coming out of my teeth, but it was my lip. But he didn't hurt me at the head. He hit me with a body shot. That was a good body shot. That's the only shot that he hit me that was decent in the fight. But like I said, I was waiting on him to be patient, to get comfortable, and I was being patient. And as soon as he was getting too comfortable. You know, he was getting too comfortable. That's when I threw a shot.
Walk us through that right, sweeping right hand that dropped him in that sixth round for the first time.
Because it was the same right hand I dropped him in the first fight. And Arreola been doing the same mistake with all his opponents, but I'm guessing his opponent don't watch his tape.
The referee let him continue, and then you went in for the finish. Walk us through how you were able to finish the fight.
I knew it was a wrap. The way I trained and to throw my power shot for 12 rounds, I knew I could knock him out because I got the power.
Deontay Wilder is your mandatory, but Vladimir Klitschko once again reiterated he wants to unify the title that was once his brother's. What's next?
Listen, with all due respect, I don't give a damn about Wilder or Klitschko right now. Right now, it's about what I won. You know what I'm saying? And I got to shout out all my people. Please, all my people. Vegas, Henderson, Canada, Montreal, Laval. I got to shout out Miami, Dade County. What's up, baby?
The man who is from everywhere in the world.
I'm not done. You got to hear this. I got to shout out to Haiti, baby. Haiti, I'm coming, baby. Michel Matelis, I got fet. So, you know what I'm saying? So, I'm very, very, very proud. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm thankful. Thank you to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, baby. I'm so happy right now. This is the best moment in my world right now. Shout out to my parents. Shout out to E, baby. What's up, baby? Little B, what's up, baby?
You earned it. Imagine trying to wrestle away the microphone from the new heavyweight titleist, Bermaine Stiverne.
Yeah, the well-traveled Bermaine Stiverne, Bernardo, Haitian-born, but grew up in both Miami and Montreal, had a taste of college football at Michigan State, a Canadian, a hopeful soon-to-be-naturalized American, fighting out of Vegas, living in Miami, and he'll be celebrating deep into the night here in L.A. We'll hear from Chris Arreola when we return. Stay with us. WBC World Heavyweight Championship is presented by Corona Extra, who invites you to find your beach. A night here in Southern California when Bermaine Stiverne found himself with his arm raised in victory as a heavyweight champion. The foolproof punch of the night. It was the right hand that changed it all, Teddy.
Exactly, on the temple, not on the chin. Throws the equilibrium off, but the most important thing in that picture is the left hand of Arreola. The left hand that did not get back fast enough to cover and to block that right hand that made Stiverne heavyweight champ of the world.
Chris Arreola was putting forth such a great effort, had great success in the second and third round when he had Stiverne in trouble at times, but then he was laying flat in the sixth. He's standing by with Bernie.
Thank you very much, Joe. Chris, I know the emotions are still raw right now. How do you feel about the way this fight played out with the knockout loss?
Come on, man. How do I feel? I'm devastated, man. I'm here to win. Plain and simple, I'm here to win, man. And before, and you know, he has a tremendous right hand, man. That's exactly what it was. And I felt like I was winning the fight. He just got me with the same right hand. Couldn't get away from it. And after that, it's all she wrote.
You know, you were ahead on two of the scorecards. 48, 47. And talk to me about what you learned about this fight, because once again, you proved that you're very tough. The first time you went down, most would have stayed down.
Man, that doesn't matter, man. I lost the fight. Doesn't matter how tough you are. A loss is a loss. I got back up. I could have got back up plenty of times, you know. Was the fight stopped a little early? I believe so. But then again, you know, the referee's there to protect me from myself. But I felt like I was winning the fight. I felt like I was winning it hands down. Caught me with the punch. Same punch you caught me before. What can I do? Nothing but tip my hat off to him, man. All respects. Even after, you know, it's boxing. It is what it is, man. I have respect for him. He has respect for me. But I felt like I was winning the fight.
How were you able to be successful early on? It was a completely different fight from the first one.
I was able to establish my jab a lot better than I did. But he has a hard head, man. I busted my hand sometimes, somewhere around the fourth round, and I couldn't throw it as powerful as I wanted to. But there's no excuses for that, man. You know, I came in this fight, I was prepared. I was ready to go the full 12 rounds, and I felt like I was winning the fight, the whole fight. But once again, he caught me. And you got to tip your hat out to him because he's the one that caught me.
How do you pick yourself up moving forward in your career?
Same way, man. You know, I got to keep trucking, man. With Seth Mitchell, if you would have beat me, I would retire. But someone like Stiverne, man, he's a world-class boxer, man. I'm back. I'm back, man. I'm gonna cause commotion in this heavyweight division, man. I'm not out, man. A couple things need to change from now on, man. No more cervezas. You know, I gotta live a clean life, man.
All right, we look forward to Chris Arreola coming back into the ring. Big success for ESPN to have this great heavyweight fight.
Thank you, Bernardo, and obviously the always expressive Chris Arreola. We apologize for the profanity used in defeat of his post-fight interview. Joe and Teddy wrapping things up here ringside. He had a lot of respect for the new champ, Bermaine Stiverne. How do you size him up, Teddy?
Listen, again, a great writer many years ago coined the phrase for this sport, the sweet science. There's been a lot of powerful guys out there, a lot of guys that they can knock down brick walls with one swoop of their hand. But they're not the guys that are always champion of the world. Ernie Shavers, he was one of those guys with a right hand, boy, he could knock down two walls. Never won the heavyweight championship. It's about more than just power. It's about more than just toughness. It's about intellect. It's about the sweet science. It's about combining the body and the mind and control over the emotion. And Stiverne did that tonight. And Stiverne won the title because not just he was the more powerful, he was the smarter. He was able to take advantage of an opportunity to land the right hand in a situation where Arreola, to his truth, had not corrected. He left that left hand out a little bit too long, covered too slow, left the opening for the right hand. So for all his toughness, for all his condition, for all the work, it was still coming down to him improving in the area of science, the area of technique. And until that's improved, well, he'll be a tough guy that we love to watch. And he'll be a guy that'll beat a lot of guys. But until he gets smarter in those areas, he will not be at the top.
And he fell in line with your thinking there. As Stiverne told us post-fight, I studied him. I was patient. He got comfortable. The plan was to crack him. Did he ever in round number six. A sensational ending to this heavyweight championship fight. A native Haitian is the champion of the world. Stiverne wins it in six. Let's check in with Tom.
Thank you, Joe. So next up for Stiverne, either Deontay Wilder or Vladimir Klitschko, or so it seems. Can Stiverne beat Klitschko? Who knows? One thing we probably learned tonight is he's got as good a chance as anybody else on the planet. His dream has come true. He is the WBC heavyweight champion of the world. As for us, we're back on Friday night, headed to the Olympic Stadium in Montreal. That's 9 p.m. Eastern on May the 16th. Delvin Rodriguez taking on Joaquim Alcin. The last fight that was held in Olympic Stadium, Sugar Ray Leonard and Roberto Duran back in June of 1980. We hope you can join us this Friday night for that junior middleweight showdown. What a night. What a fight. We've got a new heavyweight champion of the world. His name is Bermaine Stiverne. For Joe Tessitore, Teddy Atlas, and Bernardo Osuna, I'm Todd Grisham. Up next, SportsCenter. Have a great night.